So in this video, we will install a free proxy server on Google Compute Engine or Google Cloud Platform, and then we will try to route the traffic from our laptop via that particular proxy server. So this will be a live demo, and this will give us a better understanding of how proxy server really works. So let's get on with it. So let's first understand how this will work. So at first place, we will have our laptop, which is currently showing the location as UK, and it is accessing the internet from the laptop IP. But when we will deploy a proxy server on Google Cloud, we will route the traffic from our laptop to that particular proxy server, and that proxy server will then go and connect to the internet. And this proxy server is based in US. Now we will try to simulate this on Google Cloud ourselves. And we will see that once we connect through the proxy, we will see the location, the browsing location of our device, our laptop, via that particular location, which is US. So how we will achieve this today? First of all, these are some high level steps. First of all, we will install Linux Ubuntu VM on Google Cloud. This can be any other cloud, but I have used Google. You can try it on AWS or Azure. Some steps might vary. And then we will install a free proxy, which is called as tinyproxy on that particular VM. It's a very small, lightweight proxy daemon, which is free to use. Once that's done, we'll change some proxy config settings and some firewall port rules. After that, we will configure our internet connection to use tinyproxy. And then we will validate the traffic, whether it's going through the proxy or not. So let's try. So guys, as you can see, to begin with, I have browsed whatismyipaddress.com, and right now I am not using a proxy server, and you can see that the location for my laptop is showing London, United Kingdom, which is shown in this map as well. So I just wanted to show you this so that when we go via the proxy, you can visibly see the difference. So now let's go to our Google Cloud console and create a new VM instance. So I'll name it as ITK Funde Free Proxy Demo. And I will intentionally keep this proxy in US. Okay. And let me select a micro machine, because we don't need this, a heavy duty VM. And here I'll change the provider to Ubuntu, and Ubuntu x86-684 I will select 20.04 version, and the disk size I'll keep 10 GB. I'll just keep all this as is. We don't need this, but I'll enable these traffic anyways. Okay, so I'll just click on create. So now our VM is ready. So we'll try to do a SSH on this VM. So we'll click on this SSH button. So now we are trying to take SSH of this machine. So now we will install the tinyproxy. But before that, we will run some updates. Okay, then we'll type sudo apt get upgrade. So it's getting installed, all the updates and whatever is available is getting installed. Okay, so now it is done. So now we will install tinyproxy. So I'll just clear the screen. So now this will install tinyproxy on this virtual machine. Okay, so it is done. So now we have tinyproxy installed, and now we will try to make some changes in the config file for it to work on our system. Okay, So in here, we have to, so first thing which you see here is the default port for tinyproxy is 8888, okay? So we have to open this, we will need to open this on our firewall. We have to disable the loopback, I guess. Just a second, yeah, okay. So we'll just comment this. There is another setting which is called as disable via header. Okay, here it is. So we have to keep this enabled, and that's it. So we'll just press Control O, Enter, and then Control X. So the config changes are now done, and we will now restart our tinyproxy service. All right, so now this part is done. We have installed tinyproxy, we have now made the configuration changes needed, and we have restarted it. Now what we have to do is we have to go back to our Google Cloud console and go to firewall, and in here we have to create a firewall rule which allows port 8888. So we'll create a new firewall rule, and I'll put it as tinyproxy firewall rule. So for now I'll just put allow from any range which comes, okay, and I'll select TCP port 8888, okay, and this is now created. And I have selected target as all the instances in the network, but in ideal cases we might have to use tags for better security. But for now, just simply I'm creating a blanket firewall rule to allow anything coming on port 88 on any of my virtual machine, and right now I only have one. All right, so we have the firewall, tinyproxy firewall rule. So now as we have everything ready, we will take the external IP of this particular proxy server, and we will use this proxy IP in our internet options of our laptop. So for that, I'll simply select type here proxy settings, and I'll simply put the IP address of my VM, the external IP address of my VM, and I'll click on save. And now, if everything goes as expected, my region was seen as London, but what now if I refresh this? Because now it should point to my proxy server. So now you see, very intelligently, what's happening here? We have been routed to United States. As you can see here, our internet service ISP provider is Google LLC, and we are exactly in that region, Iowa, where we have created our VM, and the country is United States. If you see here, we have created it exactly in that particular area, right? So this is how a proxy server diverts traffic. So now if you want to access something in United States, you can use it via this proxy server. And I think this also clarifies why it's needed. It hides your identity, and that's why it's so useful. So I hope this was a useful exercise, guys. Go try it out. I'll try to put this code on my GitHub account or wherever possible. And feel free to try it out and see yourself if you are able to do this. So until next time, guys, keep learning, keep sharing all your knowledge, and keep hustling. Bye for now.